This presentation is a little bit different, this keynote talk from the others. I will try to make, let's say, a trip through the developments of the last decades since the first industrial revolution today, and I will take the opportunity to talk about some future trends which I believe future thoughts, which I believe that possibly the next years will be a reality. A reality like Industry 4.0 or Society 4.0, which today is based on Gardner's approach on the plateau of productivity. And some 10 years ago, we said that is not possible, like the 5G, which now is a reality. And some 10 years ago, we said that we have not devices, we have not protocols, and so forth. I will try to provide at the end of the presentation with some visions for what I think that should happen in the next decade, let's say. So, let's go ahead. I will, let me, I like not to stay there, I like to move. So here you can see the outline of the presentation, including some a few words about the history of the manufacturing systems, the Industry 4.0 smart manufacturing. This presentation, a key point of this keynote talk is the personalization and basically the mass personalization. And we will have the chance to see some issues related to that. How AI, artificial intelligence, is incorporated in manufacturing and supports or may support the mass personalization. Then AI basics for the factories of the future, automation, and some key technologies supporting the transition to the future, like Internet of Things or Industrial Internet of Things. Discussion with some points and some questions, and looking ahead, conclusions, and of course, it will be a number of key references. As you can see, each one of these slides has on the right down corner a presentation, a reference, meaning that everything presented here is documented by some references. The presentation will be in your disposal, at your disposal after the conference, and you may check and come with questions or discussions on the topic. So, I very strongly believe that we need to know from where we have started. We have started from here. I hope that this point, okay. From the first industrial revolution, job shops type. Second industrial revolution, electrical energy based mass production, 19, the American model of manufacturing. Ford, TAF, it was the main representative of that phase of industrial revolution. Then we went ahead with the dedicated manufacturing systems. We're talking about the best phase of mass production. In the middle of this transformation, we had the agile and lean manufacturing systems for making economies of scales, and including with Toyota model aspects like total quality control. Then we went ahead with the third industrial revolution, computer and integrated based knowledge in 1980, that in 80s. The appearance in manufacturing of artificial intelligence, not new, but then were well connected with manufacturing. And of course, now we are living the era of a digitalized world, digitized and digitalized world. We are talking about the fourth industrial revolution, I would say fourth scientific and fourth social revolution. And then we have what happens in Far East, in Japan since 2017, 2015 started a discussion about what they say fifth industrial revolution or society 5.0, putting the getting the human being in the center of the system. They are talking about sustainable, human-centric, and resilient systems. They transfer again the importance and the discussion point from the machine to machine, which is the main point in second industrial revolution, to human-machine interface, which will be the next. And at the end of the day, I have a small surprise about metaverse. So, because I'm a manufacturing guy, I'm a professor in manufacturing, and I want all time to make clear that manufacturing is important. I have here some numbers coming from Deloitte de Touche, 2021, how manufacturing is important. Manufacturing matters. Without manufacturing, societies are poor, have problems, and are not developed. So I have to say that 40 million jobs in United States are coming from the manufacturing sector. And here you can see some other numbers. I will not stay in each one because I need 3 hours for the presentation, in such a case, to demonstrate that manufacturing matters. Manufacturing is important. Provide taxes, provide funds for research, development, and of course supports the wealth of the nations which are strong in manufacturing. A few topics here related to the drivers for the global manufacturing competitiveness: talents, education, infrastructure, energy, physical infrastructure, economy, healthcare system. All these are affected by the issue of manufacturing, which is one of the societal activities. Not all society is manufacturing. Not all society 4.0 is manufacturing. It's one of the human activities in the framework of the society. So here you can see some nations which are very strong in the area of manufacturing, like USA, China, Germany, Japan, France, UK, other. I got there indicatively some of them. And now here we can see how the technology is a catalyst to intelligent manufacturing. Here we can see how the things happened in terms of technology. I mean here cybersecurity and advanced connectivity, Internet of Things, cloud computing, fog computing, close between the edge computing and the upper level. And then we are talking about artificial intelligence, which is very much related to some discussions made and some presentations made by other keynote speakers, like Sims Levy, who discussed a lot about data and data analytics. So, on the other hand, we have here big data sets, we have cloud manufacturing connected with fog, and of course CPS, cyber physical production systems, and the blockchain technology, which was one of the key points in the keynote presentation of the previous keynote speaker, Vladimir. So all these conclude to what we say Industry 4.0 or Society 5.0. A few words regarding the Industry 4.0 framework. Here we have 1, 2, 3 basic pylons: digitization and integration of in vertical and horizontal sense, vertical inside the companies, horizontal along the supply networks. And digitization of the product and service is not possible to go ahead with these aspects without digitization, which is different from digitalization, and of course, innovative digital business model. You cannot use your computer as a right typer. a typewriter. You need to change, we need to change in industry, in universities, in society, the business model we are functioning in terms of the new era we are living now and is expressed through the European digital agenda. The origins. Industry 4.0 is a brand new business model. No, it's not. It's not because you remember that around the 80s we had a big discussion started from the United States and not only about the computer integrated manufacturing. The outcome of the computer integrated manufacturing was islands of automation. Was islands of automation because here we have some very important issues to face, like the integration and the interoperability. Different distributed, not connected systems with high heterogeneity between them. The outcome was islands of automation. And now we hope with Industry 4.0 to integrate all this, and this will be the main achievement of Industry 4.0, to integrate what SIM failed to do. Some technology pillars, which are, of course, in the center of this digital transformation. Among them, I would like to stay mainly on big data analytics, in autonomous robots, simulation and digital twins, which of course are advanced simulation models, adaptive simulation models, and of course cybersecurity and the communication issues supported very, very, very much by 5G and sixth generation Wi-Fi networks. So augmented reality will support this transition, and of course, again, and I will insist on that, horizontal and vertical system integration. Now, again, a few words regarding the importance of the manufacturing global economy. From every 10 slides, I will get back to that. 70% of the total global trade is coming from the manufacturing. Digitalization, only digitalization, has provided 34 million jobs. We have a transformation in the job, let's say, content. We lose jobs from the one part, but we create jobs on the other hand. And it is very important to be understood. And of course, based on price water, is not a future. Industry 4.0 is here. We live on that, and our students will live in the next stages of what is today Industry 4.0. Take a look here in this number only. Only 6% only from the factories is completely digitized. This 44% will be. Our candidates are close, but the rest are away. And of course, there is a lot of job to be done in order, but we are in the process. And this is important. Now, the problem is to go to personalization now and mass personalization to connect the title, the keywords of the title of the presentation. The most important of digitalization or of personalization or mass personalization is how to integrate the user in the design and production process of a product. Four or five years ago, I ran a very big European project with Fiat, with other companies in the area. The e-custom, which had as main objective how to integrate the customer in the design of the cars, of a car. How much? A little, but it was a beginning. It was a start to discuss about mass customization at that point of time, and then personalization, and further to that, to mass personalization. So this is the point, and of course we need to have cost-effective and individualized products. I don't agree with other speakers said that the personalized products are very expensive and it is not possible to have them. The market, the demand at this point of time asks for personalized and basically for mass personalized products. Each one wants to have his car, his computer, his pullover, his tie, everything. So the demand drives the manufacturing. And the challenge is that, of course, we need quick response. We have not the tools yet to support very effectively these huge changes in production, take into consideration the mass personalization or personalization. We need to change the factory operation model. We need to establish supply networks very flexible, much more flexible than now. COVID will be nothing based on what will face the companies later on, when the market will be in equilibrium after these strange days we are living today. And of course, unique customer needs. The customers will never go back to mass production. Customers will need more and more and more personalized products, and this will be an affordable pressure for the production. So, how is achieved? Adaptive production and management control. Adaptive. Adaptiveness is the key word, the key concept for Industry 4.0. No adaptiveness is nothing. So, the second is that we need to have self-optimizing manufacturing systems. Here is coming artificial intelligence. Flexible, autonomous, and error-tolerant production systems in an adaptive way. And of course, the use of big data sets, but using artificial intelligence techniques, but the correct data. In my opinion, big data is not zettabytes of data. Big data is the amount of data I need to make a good decision and a reliable prediction. This is big data for me. Here, mass production, mass customization, and mass personalization. Let's go ahead. I will not stay in these definitions because you are familiar with them. I will stay here. Here we see that mass production was in the concept of economy of scale. Here we have mass customization, economy of scope. Some parts, like Dell, push-pull model, some parts are produced for inventory, some others are coming from the demand of the customers. So the question is where you will put the push-pull threshold. And then the mass personalization. Mass personalization makes the difference. We are talking about value differentiation now. We are talking about product as a platform for added value creation. This is the new concept for mass personalized products. Products as platforms for added value creation. So, look at this. Are coming from Accenture. 91 of the customers are more likely to shop from brands they know and they have some personal connection with them. The, let's say, non-personal advertisement and approach of the market is something of the past. And these numbers at Accenture is a really a very good think tank and developer says that. On the other hand, personalization means audience, using audience and data analytics to meet individual needs of a customer. We have to need the data not to, let's say, compensate the complexity of the systems, but to handle in an appropriate way the complexity of the systems. You remember, if we have systems with high complexity, we have high entropy. Go back to Shannon theorem and we'll check, we'll see how this could be used for reducing the noise in the system. So, for mass, this is coming from software. We are talking now for personalized software, and this is coming from another research report, saying that okay, the numbers are not so high. We're talking about 12 billion. 12 billion looks like something small versus trillions. However, it's a trend, and the trend is coming from here in 2021 to 2027. The time frame is small, and the increase is huge. I don't want to stay in this table, because here we have a lot of numbers demonstrating and justifying why personalization and mass personalization is important. It's important and will be the trend. Let's say 63 of the customers will not buy from brands that have poor personalization. You can check the references and we will find the data there, also in form of Excel, and you can elaborate them. So please take a look on these numbers and you see that the market says personalization. Some other reports say that for in the case of advanced personalization, $1 spent has a return of investment of 20, because they sell experience. It's like that brand of coffee, Starbucks, buying a sack of coffee for a few dollars and then sell one coffee for $2 or $3, because sales experience. Let's go ahead. This slide is important. It's important because it connects several things in just one slide. What is that? Is the issue of Industry 4.0, the horizontal vertical integration, robots, cobots, simulation, twins. On the other hand, the technologies, here the cybersecurity and the blockchain, which have been discussed in the previous keynote talks. And then mass personalization using the technologies like circuits, integrated circuits, and of course, communication networks. So here we have to say that another pillar, technology pillar supporting the integration between the artificial intelligence, personalization, and manufacturing is IoT. Without the platforms of Internet of Things, nothing could happen. But Internet of Things is nothing, is not an idea. It's mathematics, it's protocols. And of course, the main point here is that share and collect data with minimal human intervention. At this point of time, I'm a thing on the internet. And all of you are things on the internet, and all of you are producing data. You are producing data, all of us, you are producing data that go to the internet. So here we have a hyper-connected world, and of course this is the main questions here. Low-cost power sensor technology, without this kind of technology, it will be impossible to be manufactured. Okay? Look at this, and look at this. And connectivity and cloud computing platforms, machine learning and analytics. We go now to artificial intelligence, and of course, artificial intelligence on conventional issues. So, here, protocols. A number of protocols that are developed in order to be able to have implemented Internet of Things. From LoRa, I mean this long-range networks, wireless sensor networks, until to ZigBee, LiteOS, data distribution services, advanced messaging queue protocols, and so forth. No protocols, no integration. No maths, no developments, no integration. No integration, no Industry 4.0, no digitalization. Yeah. So, the history, a brief slide about the history of artificial intelligence. It's not something new. Started there. And you in France you have very, very important mathematicians working in different aspects of theoretical aspects of the artificial intelligence. Because artificial intelligence is algorithms. And here we can see the computing cost in terms of dollars per gigaflops, per billions of teraflops, and for the development through the years. Now we are somewhere here where the cost of computing is very low, and we can go ahead with this deep learning or machine learning or reinforced learning or structured learning or whatever learning procedures. Otherwise, nothing would be possible. And here, this slide. From this slide, I will stay only in this one, in this part here, web, AI, basically artificial intelligence 2.0, which is the distributed artificial intelligence. And this is the trend. Here we have unstructured, structured, centralized, decentralized, distributed, and unstructured. This is the point. Because the new way of making, of restoring, and of saving knowledge will not be the typical SQL databases. Will be non-SQL databases, unstructured knowledge, which will be the way of creating and of communicating with the machines, with the computers, with everything. So this is the slide. It will be at your disposal. It is well referred, and also we have made some additions and changes on that. In smart manufacturing versus intelligent manufacturing, because here in smart manufacturing, advanced smart technologies. Basically, we have automation. Here we have intelligent manufacturing, we have systems which perform manufacturing functions is of skilled humans are doing the task. Transfer intelligence from the human to machines is quite different. Because of this, we are talking about human to machine interface and not machine to machine interface. Yeah? So, this is something to be discussed. And for history, for historical purposes, let's take a look on some of the artificial intelligence techniques, like recursive neural networks, unsupervised learning, supervised learning, reinforced learning, and so forth. Of course, there are also other techniques and other methods and other algorithms which can be used for this case. What is the potential of AI in manufacturing? This is from Pricewater, 2021. Personalization, says the Pricewater House, personalization of mass products, meaning mass personalization, digitalization of products, and compliance with environmental standards and wastage. And now, a few words about how can artificial intelligence be applied in manufacturing. And why? Improve throughput, optimize supply chains, and accelerate research and development. And of course, what's driving the urgency of adoption? We have strong pressure from high revenue volatility. We have seen last times, the last 3-4 years, we have seen a lot about that. Revenue volatility, continuously finding cost savings, short production lines, times. Remember with masks, the problem. Learning and adaptability, manufacturing capacity to supply chain demands, and of course, increased need for small batch and customized goods. Here I will stay only, how can AI be applied in manufacturing? Two topics, analytics technology, data technology. Analytics is not analysis. Analysis is to know what happens or what happened at this point of time. Analytics is what will happen in the future for the good decisions and for the reliable predictions. Analysis and analytics. Here, again, from MIT Now, a review technology, a review on technology says that manufacturing, based on surveys made in 2023, says that 29% and 9% for the processes and for what they are doing and for what they will do, consider that a manufacturing business is one of the most important candidates for applying artificial intelligence techniques. Again, from the MIT survey 2020, another one, where will be applied artificial intelligence in manufacturing? Will be applied in quality control, in inventory management. We have discussed a lot today about inventory management, monitoring diagnostics, customer care, personalization of products and services, and of course, asset maintenance, predictive and prescriptive maintenance, the new trend of maintenance, the prescriptive maintenance. Oh, sorry. Here, 4 types of artificial intelligence in mass personalization. I will stay only to this one. No human in the loop. No human in the loop means, first, we may have automation. Automation means does not involve new ways of doing things. Automize what we know to do. But here, in autonomous intelligence, we are talking about artificial intelligence systems which can adapt to different situations and can act autonomously without human assistance. This is the future. This is what we are doing now, automation, with no human in loop, or what we are trying to do now, but in the future, we will do that. And about big data, here you can see how the data explode exponentially through the years. Here is 2025, and we expect to have some billions of terabytes of data produced in 2025. 2025 is 3 years from now. Yeah? And here you can see What is contribute to the creation of this data? For this reason, Amazon, IBM, Dassault have big data. Have big data because they have data centers and have a way to gather and elaborate data. Look at it here, Zoom, WhatsApp, messages, and so forth. Some example. There are companies working very hard. Danone, you know very well, is a French company using machine learning techniques to improve demand forecast accuracy. And they say that 20% decrease of forecasting errors, very important, 30% decrease of lost sales, and 50% reduction of demand planners' workload. So, Fanuc, the well-known, the best CNC controllers producer in Japan. Everything is Fanuc compatible at this point of time, like IBM compatible. So, they say the same, that they apply robotic workers. They have replaced human workers with robotic workers in order to create controllers. Can you imagine? Some other examples coming from Porsche, using AGVs in their production lines, and some other coming from BMW Group, saying that they are using image recognition in order to assure better quality. So we have concrete examples. Personalized on trends, discussion. I think that is the most interesting part of the presentation. We have some questions, some topics, some issues here. Personalized mobile customer experience. And 79% of smartphones users have made a purchase online using their mobile devices. I'm doing, from time in time, purchasing of watch faces. I like to do that, especially when I'm tired. 1 euro, 1.5 euro, it's money. Image recognition, very important. You see from BMW. Data privacy, cookless personalization, very important. To get what I want to get, not what the others want to send me through cookies. Personalization of longer customer journeys, customer loyalty, very important, and anonymous visitor personalization. The anonymity is a very important issue and should be protected. Here you can see what happens with technologies and, of course, capabilities of AI for beyond human capacity, machine learning, robotics, neural networks. And here, benefits for manufacturing. 24/7 production, safety, lower operation costs, zero defect manufacturing, and so forth. Estimations about what artificial intelligence could make for improving the human intelligence in the frame of manufacturing and other activities. It's estimated that increase from 29% of our capacity in making different jobs to 40%. It's huge. And here you can see why AI is critical. 16% of those surveyed said that 10 to 19% decrease the costs. This coming from Boston Consulting Group. And the others saying that 18% saw 6 to 10 increase of all of revenue. The things are ongoing. As time passing, I will run. Factories of the future should detect defects, deploy deploy predictive and prescriptive. I missed it here. Prescriptive maintenance. Maintenance which includes not only when happened, but the actions to be undertaken. This is the prescriptive approach of maintenance. Of course, reduce costs of small batch. Small batch means personalization. Some other points of interest, some key technologies which is developed and under development, machine vision, natural language processing. Believe me, this will be one of the issues of the future. Natural language processing. It's not possible anymore to have step protocols or different very heavy protocols developed using Express and all these kind of things. It's not possible. We need natural language processing for communicating with the equipment, with the machines, with algorithms. And this will be. And information processing. Some other points here. We have to learn from data to handling and control in an adaptive way the systems, and of course to perform supply chain optimization in an efficient way. We have seen what was the disaster with supply chains during the last 4 or 5 years. Some open issues to be faced, diverse and unstructured data. It's very difficult to have the correct data. I have worked to some extent with that, and it's very difficult. You need to use algorithms to clear the data, to compact the data, to make sensor synthesis, fusion synthesis, information synthesis. It's not a simple issue to say, I get, gather, and use data. You need a lot of artificial intelligence and mathematical advanced tools to make this issue. And of course, heterogeneity of the systems, complexity of computing power, and security threats. Now, we're concluding traditional society and society 4.0. This is the traditional society from the individual to the upper layer. And here are some of the society actions and functions. We need, for those from the universities, like me, I was not all time in the university, but now I am. You need to think, to rethink the skills and competences we provide to our students. It's critical. And now, the point of, let's say, conflict. Some people in Europe say that, okay, 4.0 is enough, Industry 4.0, Industry 5.0 is a slogan, is a buzzword, is nothing, and is included in Industry 4.0. I don't believe that Japanese spent a lot of money and have huge programs in their research and development ministry for developing what they say Society 5.0. And the difference is that here we are working with cyberspace, and they work for the whole society with new skills based on artificial intelligence. Some other points here. Here is the minister of Japan in 2017 saying that we need to introduce new skills for our students, and our students, Japanese students, should say goodbye to traditional divisions of the knowledge. So, at the end, we have European Commission saying that, okay, we are also adopt that there is a discussion about industry or society. They say Industry 5.0, and they have produced several documents and several workshops are in place discussing about this new trend, the last 3 years. And we can check it. What is human-centric, resilient, and sustainable? This is the three main hotspots from Society 5.0. And now, metaverse. It was a big discussion with the interview of Zuckerberg about Meta. You know, I spent a lot of time these days, these months, to make a division. With virtual reality, we can simulate the real world. And we try to transfer the capabilities of the real world to the virtual world. With the metaverse, we will have so advanced virtual models, and we will learn from the virtual models. It's something which I know may you can hear it a little bit skeptical, but try to check it. Try to check, because there is already a good amount of bibliography, reports, and think tanks working on that. Simulate the real world in virtual and get from the virtual and integrate capabilities of the virtual artificial intelligence and borrowed models to the human, to the real human, to the physical world. So, already there is a market size of expected 2030 to 1.5 billion euros. Here is the major outcome, the experience. You will have the presentation and take a look on that. And of course, which are the key issues here? Decentralized, interconnected, and safe and trustworthy. And key enabling technologies in order to be able to develop metaverse applications, 5G networks, and beyond. Wearable technology, artificial intelligence, avatars, and non-fungible tokens, NFTs. I have to finish, I know. Yes, but conclusions. It's time to get personalized. And with this final statement and with the intervention of my good friend here, I will stop because I know that it's time for dinner and it's almost 8 o'clock, 7:45. Thank you very much for your passion. And in case you have any question, I will be very happy to reply if I have any more time.